guys, I got a quick repair video for you today. This actually belongs to a friend of mine. This is a charging cable for an electric vehicle, particularly a Chevy Volt, but it would actually work on just about any of them. And he had an unfortunate incident with his dog. And so I'm just going to do a little quick repair video on this today, showing you know, how I'm going to tackle fixing this. This is actually a $300 to $400 piece of equipment here, so it's definitely worth giving it a proper fix rather than chucking it in the trash.
Okay, so here's the mess that we're dealing with. The first thing to do was to clean this up some, so I went ahead and cut this thing apart. And I could see some additional damage a few inches down, so I went ahead and trimmed off this whole section. Okay, the next step was to strip the insulation off. I did a few inches on each side. I wasn't sure what to do with these little ropes inside. I'm sure they're there for tensile strength, but I thought about trying to glue these together somehow, but eventually I just decided to cut them off. So, at this point there were just the 5 wires to deal with. And before we get too far along, it's time to add some heat shrink. This is a special all-weather heat shrink that has glue on the inside that forms a permanent seal. It might be a good idea to see what these wires are for. The 3 larger ones are basically power, neutral, and ground. These are the ones that carry all the heavy current, and there are 2 smaller wires that allow the car to communicate with the charging station. So my plan for repairing these was to offset each of the splices so they're not at risk of touching each other. So that means cutting some wires short and some wires long. So in the end, you can see how the 3 main power wires are arranged. Okay, next it was time to solder. The first step was to tin the wires with solder. The next step was to melt the 2 ends together. Then I usually go around with some pliers and I make sure there's no pointy edges that might cut through the insulation. Okay, I decided to try something brand new, at least to me. I've never used this liquid stuff before. Normally I use heat shrink or vinyl electrical tape, but since this is used outdoors, I wanted something that would give me a watertight seal, just in case the primary heat shrink were to get punctured. So I coated the wires and let this stuff dry for a while. It actually seemed pretty solid, but I still went back and added a second coat. And since I didn't completely trust this stuff, I decided to use some traditional tape as well, just for an extra layer of insulation. Once I was satisfied with the 3 main wires, I turned my attention to the 2 control wires. And I used the same soldering technique with them. And I also used the liquid electrical tape too. I decided to use some additional electrical tape on each side here, and this was really for cosmetic purposes only, to help reduce the lumpiness. And now it's time for that main heat shrink. I know somebody will complain that I should use a heat gun, but I don't have one, and my last one worked for about an hour before it burned up and I've never replaced it, so I just used fire. It seems to work fine. And here's the final product. It's still just a little bit lumpy, but not too bad. The last thing to do is test this. I happen to have 2 electric vehicles in the garage. My wife drives the Blue Leaf here and she charges it with the 240 volt station. I have a 120 volt station, which I rarely use because I often charge at work. We actually have 2 designated charging spots at work. Anyway, for a proper test, I had to power on my Volt and make sure to set the charging power to 12 amps. And then I unplugged my station and plugged in my friend's. And I plugged it into the car and there were no sparks or smoke, so I guess that was a good start. I checked the instrument cluster and it did show to be charging without any error messages. You can see my splice here. I'll let it charge all the way up without any problems.
Okay, I am sure there's going to be somebody down in the comment section telling me I did this wrong. Now, how do I know that? Because there's always somebody down in the comment section telling me I did it wrong. That's just the nature of YouTube. But the truth is, sometimes they're right. You know, sometimes there are better ways to do things than what I show you. And that really wasn't the point of this video though. The point was just to show that these types of things can be salvaged. They can be repaired and don't belong, you know, in the trash just because of a, you know, a cable getting messed up. So that was the point I wanted to drive home. But I do hope that you found the video interesting. This was not a planned episode. This kind of came up spontaneously. So I just went ahead and made a quick episode about it. But I have about 5 episodes actually in production right now. And They're all a little bit more difficult to make than some of my previous ones, so it is taking a while, and I apologize for that, but I think you're going to appreciate what you see, and the wait's going to be worth it. And I've got some really neat stuff to show you, so I'll see you next time.